Sony wasaratu nuka wagakima samaga singa wetin ma pamanai.
And we believe those statements were made for political reasons. So the question we have, if these investigations are independent and if these investigations are carried out independently without any sort of political interferences, how come those sensitive information was given to an international media organization? In New York Times article, at one point it says that the Hambantota port was developed without a proper feasibility study. I must deny that, and not only deny it, I have the two copies of the feasibility studies that was conducted, one by the UMP government, that was in 2003, and the second feasibility study which was conducted by President Chandrika Bandaranaike, when President Rajapaksa was the Prime Minister in that government. I also deny the fact that it says that we have received money for the 2015 presidential campaign. Now, it is totally absurd how they come up with all these stories, but knowing the history of New York Times, going through the certain articles that they have published in recent history, in the recent past, it is clear evident that even though it's a very respectable and reputed media organization, they do not worry much about the content they publish. So it is sad to see such a reputed organization is actually publishing things that are not true and that is not being confirmed.
Now this comes in the light of 3.5 years of investigation by the FCID. This government came with the solemn pledge that the FCID will hunt all the Rajapaksas who have robbed and bring them to book. The FCID has been a complete waste of time. They have not been able to bring anyone to court. They have not been able to bring anyone to justice. So now, is this government going to believe the FCID report? Okay, if they are going to believe it, then there comes another problem. There is a request from the international community for foreign judges. Are we going to accept the foreign judges? Then there is another issue. After the war, there was a Channel 9, there was a video against the atrocities, so-called atrocities of the security forces. Are we going to accept that video also? So therefore, please be careful in what you are trying to tell the people of this country. If you are going to accept the New York Times report, then you will have to accept foreign judges, then you will have to accept the Channel 9 video, and it will open the floodgates for us. And as a sovereign country, we cannot afford to do this.
New York Times පුවත්පත පිළිබඳව හොඳම සහතිකය දෙන්නේ ඇමරිකාවේ ජනාධිපති ඩොනල්ඩ් ට්‍රම්ප්. ඩොනල්ඩ් ට්‍රම්ප් මහත්මයා කියනවා New York Times පුවත්පතේ යන්නේ පට්ටපල් බොරු කියලා.
ඩොලර් මිලියන 7.6ක් චීන සමාගමකින් කප්පම් වශයෙන් ගත්තා රටේ සම්පත් විකුණන්නටත් ඒ වගේම ගියවර මැතිවරණය පාවා දෙන්නටත් කියන එක අද පැහැදිලි වෙලා තියෙනවා. ඉතින් මේ අපරාධ කරුවන්ට නීතිය ක්‍රියාත්මක කරන්න අපි සැදී පැහැදී ඉන්නවා. ඒක අපි ඉදිරියේදී ක්‍රියාත්මක කරනවා.
මට පුදුමයකුත් තියෙනවා. හැබැයි මේ නිවුස් එක ලෙටර දවස් දෙකක් විතර එනවා. මම තාමත් ආණ්ඩුව
කිසිම දෙයක් අපි රට වෙනුවෙන් කරන්නේ නැතුව මේ ගමන අවසන් වෙනවා.